Hi everyone, Katie here. Welcome back to my December daily project. Today I have days 1 and 2 all in the same video. So stay tuned to see all that I have done for these past 2 days. So this first one, day 2, my pictures actually of my band-aids from getting my vaccination booster and my flu shot, because apparently you can do those together. And if I'm completely honest, I was not feeling very good when I was making this tiny layout. I was definitely starting to feel the side effects of my vaccines. And you know what? That's okay. That's life. This is a pretty quick mini layout. I don't do a whole lot to it. And what I am doing, though, is creating a little like Instax mini frame, because I do use my Instax printer for all of my December project photos. So I'm making that with my We Are Memory Keepers frame punch board, and I make it quite easily. That thing is so easy to use if you like to make frames, especially Instax frames, and I'm actually just using the paper that I used from day one. I wanted this to be a mostly red but with green accents little layout, because obviously that's Christmassy, and I wanted to use this red paper. It's actually got gold foiling on it as well, and I thought that was one something that would be easy to do that I wouldn't need a whole lot of embellishment on, because like I said, I was not feeling very good, and I wanted to use a nice paper because, you know, as much as this vaccine has made me feel very bad, I am happy to have gotten it to be able to help, you know, keep my family, friends, and students safe, as well as myself. So, you know, doing what I can to help out. So I felt like that deserved a sparkly page. So on that little journaling card, that's a little ephemera bit that I have had, and it makes it to be a nice journaling card. That's exactly what I'm writing, that I got my shots. I wasn't feeling so great after them, but that's okay. I'm happy to have gotten them done. So I'm popping this up on some foam tape and then putting it in that open space. Now, there are so many... there's already so much going on because of the different patterns and things that I really don't feel like I need a whole lot more in this layout, though I try a few more things just to, you know, see what can be done or what I could do. But ultimately I decide just on these two little stickers, and that finishes up my day 2 layout. So coming up now, I've got day 3, where I have been on the couch all day, recovering again from this vaccine, but I'm starting to feel better, so I do a little bit more with my mini layout. I take some Basil Marshmallow cardstock, and I'm going to do a little mixed media on it. I have the scrapbook.com Pops of Color. These are, one is Rudolph Red, and the other is Holly Green. These were actually some free gifts over the Thanksgiving holiday week, and I had not used them yet, but I was really excited to. You can see I'm still trying to pull out the, it has like a little stopper in there when you first get them to, I guess, keep them fresh and prevent them from exploding or anything like that. Now, I put a little line of both the red and the green down on one edge of the page, and here I am taking my scraper tool. This is also from scrapbook.com, but I mean, there are a million scraper tools that you could use to do this. And I just kind of drag the mixed media down along the page until I've used it up, you know? And so it creates kind of an uneven red and green stripe. It would probably be better if I'd, you know, used this before or practiced before, but I like the vibe that it gives, and it's okay that it's not perfect. I never go for perfect when I do mixed media, because usually that's the beauty of it, is that it's not perfect. It's very artsy. Now I'm looking through my little ephemera box again, my like winter Christmassy ephemera, and nothing is like majorly screaming to me. And I think that's mostly because here in Kentucky, we had like the day was like 60 degrees. It was super, super warm. So I have all these ephemera bits of like mittens and hats and let it snow and like, no, that's not what it feels like, at least here. I guess I'm ready for a little bit colder weather here. We usually do get colder weather, maybe not quite snow, but definitely not, you know, 60 degrees. So we'll see what happens. I end up grabbing a tag. It does say to from, you know, like I'm supposed to put it on a gift, but I decide that that's going to be my journaling box. And I just write about how today was a warm day, and it doesn't really feel like Christmas because of that. And I spent most of my day on the couch, like I said, recovering from my shot. But now, let's see, I'm about 28 hours out from getting the shot, and I finally am starting to feel better, so that's good. But I don't really have a picture or anything for today because, I mean, me laying on the couch and doing nothing. You know, I did not take any pictures and nothing really felt very Christmassy. So today I don't even have a picture for this layout, which is okay. I don't think I need one, especially because not every day is a perfect day. Like today was, you know, very useful. I am glad that I got my shot, but I was not feeling any extra holiday spirit today, other than just sitting on the couch in front of the lit up Christmas tree. That was nice, but not a whole lot of, you know, Christmassy vibes going on today, and that's okay. So I've got my little journaling tag down, and I use a sparkly red brad to adhere it, and now I grab a few pieces of ephemera. One says peace, and I like that because, I don't know, I felt like it kind of went with the vibes of the day, and I, especially how I like wasn't feeling very good. It's like I could just use peace. And then the other piece that I grab is the Are You Yeti for Christmas, and I think that kind of goes along just because I said, you know, it didn't really feel like Christmas yet, which is okay. We'll get there. And I don't know, I just kind of felt like that went with what I was going for. So I'm putting these pieces down. I use double-sided tape for the little circle that says peace. And then I use the foam tape for the one that says Are You Yeti for Christmas. I thought it gave it some nice dimension, just kind of differentiated it from the other side. And I pop my little number on here. It's hard to tell, but it has red glitter around it, so I tried to put it in the green area. I thought that looked nice. And then I want to add a little something extra. So I'm looking through all my embellishments, and I decide to use one of these sparkly, like, green Christmas trees. I just pop that down there. I think that kind of makes, like, a triangle of the sparkle with the number, the tree, and the brad. And then I finish it off actually with my Crayola thin marker, making a little border around the edge of my mini layout. And that will be all that I do. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.